It's Anne from The Useless Crafter. Thanks so much for joining today. If you haven't already, please subscribe. I appreciate the support in all ways, whether it's comments, questions, liking, and also subscribing. All right, so I did these bulbs in a previous tutorial where we added polycrylic and then we did the glitter. And then on this one, we added the gold foil, gold flakes on top, which I am loving the way these look. This has faux snow in it. So the faux snow is from Dollar Tree, so it's super cheap. And I really like it because it's thicker than glitter. So I like that look, but you know, I think it's just because I like chunky glitter. This one is chunky glitter. So I didn't do the fine glitter that I've done in past years, but you can look that up on my YouTube channel. I have that as well, so you can see that. So today I want to show you how to personalize them. So we're just going to add vinyl to it. It's a curved surface. So I just wanted to talk you through that. And then I also want to show you, cause these are on the smaller side. They were, from Michael's in a big, like, assorted bucket. And so I bought it, maybe 2 years ago, after Christmas when it was super on sale. And I believe the sales are going on right now anyway, so you could do that too. I personally like the flatter discs more than I like these round ornaments, just because I feel like it's easier to personalize because it's more flat. But if you just look at overall, I mean, the round bulbs are so pretty. It's just whether or not you want to deal with the headache. But I'm going to show you the tips so that you can apply it easily. Now I cut two names because I have two bulbs, right? I wanted to do one for Sarah. And so I cut the name twice. I designed it once where, you know, like typed out the name once, welded it. And then when I went to the make it page, I changed the number to two and then applied it. So it should have cut the same two identical ones. And I don't know if you'll be able to see in the screen because it is foil, but the funny thing is one cut out perfectly where, you know, even the thin parts, you could see that it's not so thin, which is the one I'm going to use, and I'm going to put it on here so you'll be able to see it. But the funny thing is when it cut on this one, the thin areas were so much thinner. I just thought it was so weird because it wasn't as if I typed the name twice. It was the same name duplicated, so it should have given me the same results. So I just feel like sometimes, you know, with your Cricut, you just don't know what you're getting. And I'm gonna weed this one just so that you can see the difference. You see how like the R right there, let me see, the little line connecting the R to the A is completely gone. It was so thin. The R is just super thin, as well as the S right here going into the A. So let me weed this one. I wanted to show you this one. So Sarah is obviously a much shorter name, right? As opposed to Charlotte. So because I'm making the name longer, I had to shrink it a little bit so that the name doesn't wrap so far around the ornament. And so this one's going to be smaller. I wanted to show you this one because it's all crinkled by matte where this vinyl laid was not as sticky. So because of that, it bubbled up. So you want to make sure that when you're putting vinyl on a mat or any material, actually, you want to use your brayer. Let me grab the brayer. You want to use the brayer on your mat. So you want to put your material on the mat and then you want to use the brayer to get it to really stick down. You want everything to be sticking really flat onto the mat so that you get a clean cut. Clean cut, not a clean cut. Let me show you what this looks like when I go to try to weed it. And I saved the mistake just because I thought it was a good learning experience for everybody. I knew it, but yeah, sometimes I just don't pay attention. And I had the same problem on this one. Look at how thin it cut. Look at my H isn't even coming out. The little tip, it's just horrible how inconsistent my maker has been. The T is so thin. You can see over here, look at the difference between the H going into the A. You can actually see it on this one. It's non-existent. So just keep an eye out for that. You don't want to go too thin. Like this is just too small, I think. So Sarah was a decent name to cut. But even, you know, I'm going to weave this one so you can see the difference. Oh, that was the one that was messed up. And then this one should weave perfectly because I can see it. Yeah, it's so pretty. I love this font. This font is, it's Desianti, I think, from Creative Fabrica. So I'll definitely link it for you. But you can see this one cut perfectly. Even though it's thin, it, you know, it was fine. So we're going to put this one on this bulb. So what you want to do is when you're doing a round surface, you really want to make sure that your transfer tape fits perfectly. You don't want excess because it just makes it more difficult for you to transfer it. Normally I'll transfer, you know, I'll use any scrap and I won't cut it down. But on this one, you're going to want to. So I'm going to pull this off. Make sure you get, you know, you get this to really stick. And then what you're going to want to do is because it's a round surface, well, let me make sure I can get this up. And this is super thin. So you can see it's, I mean, it's such a delicate, beautiful font. So you just got to be careful when you're lifting this up that you don't pull it so quickly that you actually just rip it right off. So here is my name. It is a lot easier if you cut little slits on here so that it can fold and curve with your round bulb. And actually what I want to do is I actually want to even cut, trim the excess off even more, and then I'll cut it down. So just trim around it as much as you can, right? Sometimes you can't, but in this case you can. So let me move that out of the way. And then you just want to cut little slits in it so that you don't want to cut the foil, like your actual vinyl, but your transfer tape, you want to cut little slits in it just so that, like I said, it just gives you more room to move your transfer tape around the bowl. Okay. So I'm going to put it over here. And okay, so I'm going to go put it down where the R is. I want to start in the middle, and then I'm going to curve. I'm going to use my finger and push it down going out. This gives it more room to find a place to get rid of bubbles. If you go from left to right, you're giving it no space. If you go from middle, there's, you know, just an A left on this side, an A and an S on this side. It just gives you a little bit more flexibility. Now, once you have it down, you do want to use this as much as you can. You want to press down so that you get all your bubbles out, that it's sticking really well. You also want to let this cure. You don't want to touch it or do anything with it so that it sticks to the bulb really, really well, and then you won't have any issues. Okay, I think we're good. And now, yay. Yay, no bubbles. And you can see the name right there. It's super pretty. It's really delicate and fancy looking. I love it. I'm actually not putting this on the tree, but I'm using this. I'm going to stick a ribbon through it and tie it on a present. So there you have it. My other tip for this is you don't want a really thick design. So I wouldn't do... just the more vinyl you have, it's going to be harder to curve it. And sometimes if the design is too big, there's nothing that you can do. It's going to bubble up. So I love the names because names, you know, you have more space for the bubble, the air bubbles to pop out. So this one really, like, I'm trying to see how close I can get so that you can see it. There are no bubbles on it. It's a really beautiful, beautiful font, beautiful colors. It'll be great on the theme. All right, so I have that one. I don't have this one to do because nothing cut well. Actually, you know what? I have one. I have a gold one, but it's not going to be pretty with gold. Ah, we'll try it. Okay, so I do have a piece of transfer tape left. Oh. Sorry, I don't know what fell. Okay, I have, oh, just enough. Just enough on here. So we'll put this on here. This is a different font. This is Hanaberry Cool, which is also my other favorite on Creative Fabrica. And with Creative Fabrica, if you want to give it a try, I love it. My trial subscription is only $1. So for 1 month, you get it for $1. So you can try it. If you don't like it, just cancel it. But if you like it, make sure that when you do the $1 trial, that you use my link and my code. The code is theuselesscrafter30, because if you choose to keep it, you'll get 30% off automatically every month. So you definitely want that. The reason why I like it, though, is that all fonts and images come with a commercial license so that you can use it and then, you know, sell it in your products or sell it on your site. You know, like if you put the name or something, then the font comes with it. So, all right. So there we have that. I'm going to trim this like I did the other one. So I just don't want any excess because it makes it so hard when it sticks down and I can't, you know, press down on the vinyl. Okay, so I'm going to move that to the side. And then now I'm going to cut my slits. And same thing with this one. This one's a little bit longer of a name. So I want to make sure that I stick it in the middle. And then once my middle is down, I'm going to go one side at a time, one letter at a time, and really get it so that it sticks down there without any issues. And then I'm going to go on this side, same thing. I'm really going to push it out. Okay, good. Then I'm going to take this and make sure that get it really down. All air bubbles are out, which I think it's looking good. Okay, I think I'm good here. I'm gonna lift this up. Yay! All right, let me see if you can see it. Let me get a good angle. You know what? Let me see if I turn this off, if it's better. I'm trying to get a good, see. I'm not getting a good angle on this. I'm going to take the picture outside. It's really pretty. This one you could see better, right? Yeah. All right. So I hope that was helpful. And tag me when you do your ornaments. I would love to see them. But these are great on wrapped presents and then also on the tree, of course. I've done in the past, I've had my daughter write her name, so I'll transfer over, I'll upload her handwriting of her name with the year on it. If you have really young kids, I've done her portrait before, so just her side portrait and did that on an ornament. I definitely prefer a flatter surface for that one. And I have something like this from Michaels. So this would make the portrait so much easier to do, right? And then 1 year, when she didn't know how to write her name yet, but she drew something, I uploaded that drawing and did that in vinyl. So there's so many different things that you can do to capture and it's a keepsake. I absolutely love it. So, all right. I hope that was helpful. Let me know. I'll see you guys next time. Happy holidays.